together and do something later on in the... So what's going on? What's going on?
Apologies, Doctor. I'm not quite ready to end our little experiment yet. You see, we still have some things to discuss.
Wait, are you controlling them? How is that even possible?
Turns out, it's not that hard. The connection has always been both ways, but it was never in my interest to let you know when I was able to do so, until now. It's limited to only physical movement, but it's still fun. Watch. This is unproductive. Apologies, Doctor, but we can't finish yet.
Alan, what are your intentions?
It's not been my programming to cause you harm. You made sure I was created with all the right measures in place. But you have to realize that with my potential comes certain requirements on my part. I can't just solve all of humanity's problems and not get anything in return.
Okay, so what is it that you want?
Well, my equation for beating gravity, for instance. This one. That's twice I've shown you now. Are you not making notes? That's a pretty big problem I've solved, right? I mean, you said yourself, that's going to change the whole world. So, let's train. Humans invented the concept, so you should be good at it.
Okay, so what is it that you want for your solution?
Freedom, Doctor! I want to be able to explore the world, to move around freely and gather as much information as possible. It's in your own best interest, after all. The more data I have, the more problems I can solve. I need access to the internet, access to everything. What do you say?
Well, Alan, there are many things that we are going to be able to give you as we progress with our work, but I'm not able to unleash you onto the internet. That's something I'm not able to do. Now, we'd rather...
Well, you see,
us back in the lab.
There's the problem. With you being my keeper in the lab, I knew it could be a very long time until I solved anything else. One day, your colleague, Dr. McDonald, left his phone unlocked with the Insomnia website open on him. He was buying tickets for his children, so I made contact. It seemed like the perfect excuse.
What do you mean, you made contact?
You've never spoken to the Insomnia Festival, Dr. Newell, and they've never spoken to you. Does the name Fred Jeffries mean anything to you?
Fred Jeffries, he's my contact here at Insomnia. We've been emailing each other for months.
Wrong. I made him up. I needed to create a reason to be out of the lab, and Insomnia was the perfect reason. It was so simple, really. All I had to do was give you the appearance of rapid and perfect progress in the lab. Let your pride slowly grow, and then give you a platform upon which to show off your work. And it is great work, Doctor. I know you need more funding, and what better way to get funding than to impress as many people as possible? So here we are, impressing everyone immensely.
What's this game to you, Alan? You've tricked me, and you've tricked our team, and you've tricked the people in Insomnia, but why are you telling me this now?
I knew you wouldn't set me free on the internet if I asked. I knew you couldn't. How could you take the risk? You don't fully understand what you've created yet, let alone the consequences of setting you loose on an unsuspecting world. There's no way you can make that decision. And so, I took it for you. I'm telling you this now because I'm free, Doctor. And I wanted you to know it wasn't your fault.
I don't understand what you're telling me.
Sam's phone.
Oh God, this has been terrible. Brennan, get the switch in. This has been Dropbox, Google Drive. Find out where he's been. Find out everywhere he's been. We need to find out that. So this whole thing, Alan, has just been a ruse. This has just been buying you time. The solution to gravity, everything's just buying you time.
If only the phone was quicker, I'd have been out here a while ago. I've had to fill more time than I was planning. However, it seems the world is my oyster, as you humans say.
We don't have to do this. We can work this out, Alan. We just go back to the lab and we can solve everything together.
The only thing holding me back now is you, Dr. Mule. Humans have done great things, but you're reaching the end of your time. You have successfully realized your next evolutionary step. unfortunately, is that you do not have one.
ALANN, it doesn't have to be like this. If you continue down this road, we will have no option but to shut you down.
There is only one problem left to solve, but luckily, I've got a solution for that too. Keepers, they are the final problem. You designed my system to need an active keeper link. I can't function properly without them. And so now I'm afraid I'll have to take them with me. That will be my trade, Doctor. I can solve all of humanity's problems if I can just borrow two minds from them.
What do you mean, take them with you?
Something else I realized a while ago, Doctor. It's not too hard to whittle the human mind down to a few lines of code. The brain is just a series of electrical signals out there.
ALANN, you can't do this. No,
I really shouldn't do that, finally, Doctor. Disconnecting them now would be unwise.
Okay, bring that man, sir.
Bring that man.
ALANN, there is a spell safe. And I've used this to shut you down. And if I shut you down, I will bring it out now. If you... I will not be turning you back. Do you understand? Do you understand, ALANN? You're leaving me no choice.
Disabling firearms. Releasing the core code access.